we all remember that.
No.
Not we should. No. We gotta remember all of this, right?
No.
So let's go back. What was our first call leading up to the American Revolution? So what was our first act we talked about?
The Sugar Act.
Sugar Act. What is the Sugar Act tax?
Sugar and molasses.
What is molasses?
Sugar. Honey.
A type of sugar.
It's like a liquid sugar. Did we try it in here?
Yes.
Did you like it?
No.
Yes. Alright. What was our next act after the Sugar Act? Raise your hand so that I can call you.
What
was the next act after the Sugar Act? Stamp Act. What did the Stamp Act tax?
All paper.
All printed paper. Okay. So we have Stamp Act. What act do we have after the Stamp Act?
Quartering Act.
Quartering Act.
Angela, what did the Quartering Act do?
Exactly.
Start off with this. Everyone is paying attention. What does quarter mean?
Quarter.
Oh. Money.
What does quarter mean from our vocab that we talked about? What is it, Angel? To live with. Therefore, somebody answer the question for me. What is the quartering act? Story.
When the Redcoats lived in the colonists' houses and they paid for them.
Yeah, how much did the Redcoats have to pay to live with the colonists?
Zero.
It was for free,
they gave
right?
them to eat.
They gave them to eat. Yeah. They housed them. They gave them somewhere to live, somewhere to sleep. And they didn't have to pay anything. Hey, are we all paying attention?
Yes. Hey, you've got a test coming up and you have a quiz next week, so.
All right, so after our quartering act, what do we have? Emily. The Townsend Act. What is the Townsend Act tax? Yeah, glass, lead,
paper,
tea. All right, what else did we talk about under the Townsend Act? Remember, if you can't remember, you can use your what?
Journal.
Do you remember what that was called? It was part of the Townsend Act. What was the exact term we gave? No, Christian. What is it?
If you need to go, look at right now, open your journal to the Townsend Act. If you don't know, go to your agenda page.
So there is something in the Townsend Act where Angel kind of explained it for us, where the soldiers or the Redcoats were allowed
37 to 38. Let's go back and reference.
Christian. What is it, Christian? It's the Writs of Assistance. And what is the Writs of Assistance, Christian?
Open your journal right now
to 37. So they were able to search without having to ask for permission to go into their houses. They're looking for what?
Smuggled goods.
Smuggled goods.
So right now, go to 37. I want you to look at this. We have to reference back to this because we learned it. It's important that we understand what happened in the past. We know why they're going to complain about it now. So let's just have somebody read this.
The Writs of Assistance allowed British soldiers to search homes and businesses for smuggled goods.
All right, that is a part of what act?
Townsend Act.
Yes,
the Townsend Act. All right, the Townsend Act led to what event afterwards? Jocelyn. No, not the Tea Act. What did the Townsend Act lead to? No? Hey, why are we guessing? We should know this. What is it, Angel? The Boston Massacre. Somebody please explain to me when you raise your hand what the Boston Massacre was. Jonathan. Hold on, I can't hear Jonathan because other people are talking and that's kind of disrespectful. The killing of five people. Who killed these five people?
Redcoats.
The Redcoats. How many Redcoats were charged with murder?
Nine.
Oh, nine, right? So who was this person defending the Redcoats?
John Adams.
It was John Adams, and he is whose cousin?
Samuel
Adams' cousin. All right. So we had the Boston Massacre. Was it really a massacre?
No.
Why not?
Only
five people died. But they called it the Boston Massacre. Why?
So they can.
One person at a time.
Can somebody tell me? So the Redcoats had the weapons, the colonists didn't. So what was Paul Revere trying to convey?
They were shooting at innocent, unarmed.
Yeah. So they're shooting at these innocent and unarmed people, right? He's trying to portray the Redcoats as really bad people, right? So what happens after the Boston Massacre, Jocelyn?
The T
Act. What is the T Act tax?
All
tea. All tea.
They could only buy from the East.
Thank you. They could only buy from the East India Company, right? Were the colonists happy with that?
No.
Why not? Y'all can tell me no, but you need to explain to me why.
Because
what? Why were they unhappy?
Because they could only buy from...
Because they were being captured out of representation and they could only buy?
From one company.
From one company. They didn't have a choice, right? They didn't have a say. Was that super upsetting to them?
Yes.
So after the TF comes what, Luis? What happens at the Boston Tea Party? Tea out into the harbor. Why did they dress up as Indians?
So they don't get blamed,
right? Does the king eventually find out?
Yes.
Yes, he does. And so that leads us to what final act? I want to hear from somebody who I haven't called on. Somebody, I need you to raise your hand so that I can call on you. Intolerable Act. And what does the Intolerable Act do? You have help right in front of you. What does the Intolerable Act do?
Oh, yeah. They threw the
No, that's Boston Tea Party, right? We just discussed that. So what's the Intolerable Act?
Closing the harbor.
So they closed the Boston Harbor. And this leads to what war are we going to start talking about?
The American Revolution.
The American Revolution. All right, so we finally reached the American Revolution. What happened? What's the first battle we have? What is it? Lexington and Concord, right? So who are they searching for? Christopher, who are they searching for at the beginning of Lexington and Concord? Samuel Adams and who else? And John Hancock, that is correct. All right, so they're searching for these people. Do they find them?
No.
Why not?
Because someone was alerting them.
They're already gone.
Right, so yeah, who is that someone, Lise? That alerts them?
Paul Revere.
Yeah, Paul Revere. He tells them, hey, the British are
coming.
Was it really the British?
No, the Red Coats.
The Red Coats are coming, right? So, after this, we have the Lexington and Concord battle has already started, and we have our first
battle.
Victory.
Yeah, we did have our first battle and our first victory, but we also meet where? The first?
Lexington.
First of the American Revolution.
What is it? First Continental Congress. Do they discuss declaring independence there?
No, boycotting.
No, they discuss what?
Boycotting.
They discuss boycotting.
Without. Who can give me a really good definition about what no taxation without representation means? Angel, can you give me a definition for that? What does that mean? No taxation without representation. Can you tell me?
Taxing without their say.
A say in what?
If they want to
what? Okay, but what else do they not have? Are they able to represent themselves?
No.
And what's the name of the government in England called?
Parliament.
Yep. So do they have a say in Parliament?
No.
No. Are they able to send representatives over to England and represent the colonies in Parliament?
No.
No.
Alright, so, Danny, what document do the colonists decide to write up before they start to do the Declaration of Independence?
Their last effort.
Or they try to make peace, or they try to just talk to the king again. The olive branch what? Yeah, they threw it away. Gustavo, did he even get a chance to read it? No. So the colonists are what? They're angry. And then they meet at the Second Continental Congress. What happens at the Second Continental Congress? Demir. What do they finally start to draft and write up?
The document we talked about yesterday. This is very important. Where can you look at your notes from yesterday and the day before?
What's the name of the document? Yeah, the Declaration of Independence. We finally start writing it. Who's writing it? Who's writing
Thomas
it?
Jefferson.
Thomas Jefferson. Where can you look if you can't remember who
there it is?
Thank you, Jocelyn, for helping us out. All right, so we start talking about the Declaration of Independence. When they write this Declaration of Independence, do they just kind of give him a document and they're like, here, just sign it and we can be free from it?
No.
What do they have to do? They have to list what? Their complaints, their reasons as to why they want to be
free.
They want to be free from who?
The king.
The king, right?
Do you think if the king gets this, he's going to recognize it? He's going to be like, okay, you can be your own country?
No.
He's going to be like, okay, colonists, write this document all you want, right? But think about it. If you're breaking up with your boyfriend or you're breaking up with your girlfriend, you're not just going to say, hey, it's over. What are you going to do? You're going to give them what?
Reasons
why you're breaking up. Oh, you posted an Instagram picture with somebody else, right? You would give them reasons why you're breaking up with them. So what are the colonists doing? Are they giving them reasons why they're declaring independence?
Yes,
and these reasons are called what?
Grievances. Okay. What is this, Angela? What is it right here? What is it, Angela?
Letter R.
This is a G.
No, the one S.
Okay. We've kind of said the word a couple of times today, so you should.
Yes. Quit being silly.
Awesome.
Okay. Somebody help her out. How do you say that?
Grievances.
So try to say that word.
Grievances. Well, what's a grievance? A complaint, right? So let's go ahead and look up here, put your pencils and whatever you're holding down. Let's look up here. So we're going to look at an example of some of the grievances, okay? He has imposed taxes on us without our consent. When they're saying he, the colonists are talking about he, who are they talking about?
The king.
Who are they talking about?
King.
The king, right? So the king has imposed taxes on us without our consent. What is specifically happening here? What is an example of some of the taxes he imposed?
Paper goods.
What was the name of that act?
Stamp
Act. What's another tax that they imposed? Christopher. What is it? Yes, speak up. Quartering Act. Was the Quartering Act taxing?
No.
So think of another one. So we have Stamp Act already. What's another one you can use? Where they're taxing them. Yep, you can use your journal to look if you need to. That's what it's there for, to help you. What's another example of a tax? The Tea Act. What were they taxing?
Tea.
All right, so if we're talking about imposing taxes, what do you think our answer is going to be over here of the event that led to that?
What's going to cause us to complain about imposing taxes? It's very simple, y'all are overthinking it.
What is it? You said taxes, right? Yeah, you did.
So what's it gonna be? What's gonna cause us to complain about the taxes? Well, what's it gonna be, guys?
Taxes.
The taxes.
All right, let's read our next one. Who is this again? The king has taxed our printed paper, even our playing cards. What are we talking about?
The Stamp Act.
Is that going to be your answer? Nico, look. Stand back! You guys are right! Alright, so let's look at this last one. The king, has accused us responsible of the massacre with his redcoats. What event are we talking about? How do you know that?
Because it says redcoats.
And what else? What happened to redcoats?
A massacre.
Was it really a massacre?
No.